First of all, it's my privilege and honor to be here. This is my first visit to Central India, thanks to IMI. I like to call myself as an accidental entrepreneur. It's not that I thought what I want to get into, then I became what I am. It's a more of accidental discovery of my journey to into what I am today. Matrimony.com, what today is known, were not existing 18 years ago. I was in US, wanted to do something in the internet. I was very good in programming. Like many entrepreneurs, while they want to do something, but the challenge of where to begin, that's actually the many entrepreneurs. They want to do something. It's more like if you want to draw a beautiful picture, but the challenge is where to begin. That's a problem many entrepreneurs has. I was no exception. Since anyway, I was in the US, a lot of people like me from Tamil Nadu was there. I thought, why not let me do something targeting the Tamil community? I was running a Tamil community website in US targeting a Tamil community. It had various sections, make friends, discussion forum, festival reminder. Matrimony was one of the sections. I was doing a lot of my weekends and after office hours. Somehow realized the matrimony sections was getting a lot of traffic, like there are a lot of bachelors like me. So I realized that this is an opportunity. After working for 2.5 years of this building the community website, I let go of the community website, got exclusive matrimony venture. Since I was running a Tamil community website, the approach I took was, instead of running a single website, the approach I took was segmentation approach. Exclusive matrimony site for the popular linguistic language-based communities in India. That's why the Bharat Matrimony happened under various segmentation like HindiMatrimony.com for Hindi-speaking people, MarathiMatrimony.com, Telugu Matrimony, Tamil Matrimony. That's why the BharatMatrimony.com evolved. In fact, our journey began post the dot-com bubble bust that has happened. In fact, really worked well for us. Because of the dot-com bubble that has busted, the company like us, we didn't have any money. We could able to tie up with bigger portal like Sify, Rediff, MSN as a matrimony channel partner. And we also leverage PR to get the profiles. So it's not about setting the business, because matchmaking, how do you make money? We had to get more profiles. So we tied up with the bigger portals. We're getting a lot of traffic. Then able to monetize that traffic. The first step was setting up the portal. The second was getting the profile. In 2000, when I moved to India, obviously challenge of the payment. The credit card usage was not that popular in India. Today, e-commerce is really big, growing big in India because of cash on delivery. We are the first company to realize that if you had waited for the credit card payment to happen, then you are waiting too long. We are the first company to start with doorstep collection. Because of the reason, we started setting up operations across India so that it could able to facilitate the support at the local market, at the same time also facilitate collection at the in major cities. We also tied up with Sify. Sify.com that point had close to 3,000 cyber cafes across India. We tied up with the Sify Cyber Cafe, where people can go into the Sify Cyber Cafe to make payment. We tied up with India Post, because India Post is the world largest network in the world. They have 1,75,000 offices across India. We have tied up with them, where people can go to the post office to make a payment for BharatMatrimony.com. We also tied up with ICICI Bank, various banks, where people can go to this bank and make a payment for BharatMatrimony.com. Basically, those days, while we didn't have the sufficient our own support, we leveraged the existing channels to collect payment for BharatMatrimony. Today, we don't use the Sify India Post, we still use bank, but today, across India, we could able to collect payment using our own channel. Within few hours, we could able to collect payment. That's the kind of strength what I built in the last 15 years. So we got the website. We know how to get profiles through online marketing, through various other marketing initiatives. We know how to monetize. Then the story goes. Because matrimony is such an important thing, because when I came to India from US, people told it is very difficult to make this business successful because people are very conservative. Would Indian be comfortable putting their profile online? We realized that, yeah, trust is an important factor. We have to build the trust. So right from the beginning, we ensured that each and every profile gets into BharatMatrimony is validated manually. we ensure that only the proper contents goes into the website. Again, matchmaking not looking at only the name, age, other information. We have to have a lot more information. What it was, a very basic information. Today we are getting a five-page information from profile, family details, partner preference, hobbies and interests, all the details. Today we are able to give the complete picture of the prospect, bride or groom. We are the first company in the world to do 100% mobile verified profile only. Each and every profile in Bharat Matrimony, the people have to give the mobile number, they have to verify the mobile number. Through IVR, through SMS, even those who don't verify the phone number, we call and verify to ensure that the safety or some kind of basic verification is taken care. So right from the beginning, the company has cautiously worked on how to make Bharat Matrimony the most trusted matchmaking player so that more people can come and make use of our services. The trust has been today Bharat Matrimony known for the trust. Recently, the brand trust report says Bharat Matrimony is the most trusted matrimony website. Then, right from the beginning, the thinking was how to take real-time matchmaking into the virtual world. That was our thinking. The matchmaking happened in the real-time. How the typically matchmaking happens, how to take that matchmaking into the real-time world, virtual world. We know the horoscope, a lot of people believe in horoscope matching. In BharatMatrimony.com, if you enter date of birth, time of birth, the horoscope generated according to your language, according to the format. Horoscope has multiple format. I didn't know earlier. There's a South India format, there's a North India horoscope format, there's an East India horoscope format. If you enter date of birth, time of birth, automatically horoscope generated based on the format, based on the language you want. It's not only that generate the horoscope, it automatically matches with the brides or groom. I got married through BharatMatrimony.com. That point of time, horoscope match was not there. I remember interacting with my father-in-law. I told him, look, I want to talk to my fiancé wife. He said, no, wait for the horoscope to match. I got to wait impatiently whether the horoscope is going to match or not. Luckily, it matched. Then only allowed me to speak to my wife. And today, you don't worry about it because Bharat Matrimony automatically shows whether the horoscope is matching or not. So you don't have to contact the bride, then thinking whether it's matching, then father coming and saying, sorry, not matching. So today, horoscope matching is automatically shown on each and every profile. Also realize that in matchmaking, people do the reference check. The bride or groom, you want to know whether what the characters and other information. We realize that how to take this information to online, reference check. In Bharat Matrimony, people can add references. If you are looking for a life partner, you can come and say, please talk to my uncle and aunt. This is what they talk about me. You can give the contact number. You can give your colleagues contact details. Or you can ask your uncles, aunt, relatives, friends, come and talk about you. So basically, people want to know more about you. Apart from the information which you had given, they can look at the information given by the references, so it's built the credibility. So we have that feature in BharatMatrimony.com. Then the trust badge. Yeah, I can put whatever information I want. I can put whatever education, I can put whatever occupation I want. In Bharat Matrimony, if you give your education certificate, we get that trust badge for education. If you put your salary certificate, you get the trust badge for occupation. So if you put identity proof, government issued ID, license, passport, you get the identity badge. So Bharat Matrimony, people can put those information, they get the trust badge. Recently we started a free doorstep verification in Chennai and Delhi, where people can opt for this service, where go to the doorstep, verify this information, that's called free verified in person. Then we also launched certain feature, we did not become successful. One of the feature was video profile. Wouldn't it be nice to kind of people to come in front of video to talk about what they are? We launched the feature 10 years ago, did not become successful. We thought that point of time people did not have the video camera. All our offices had set up the video camera. I thought people come, did not come. Then I realized that people are very shy in front of the camera. That feature got removed. Then he thought, okay, people are very uncomfortable putting the video. Wouldn't it be nice to listen to the prospective voice? You like the girl, wouldn't it be nice to listen to her voice? We thought, okay, why not do the voice matrimony profile? We tied up with the Airtel. Okay, people can call the Airtel number, which is 6 rupees per minute. You can record your message. The prospect can listen to it. It was not picking up. We thought, okay, probably people are not willing to pay 6 rupees per minute. Then we have set up a free voice matrimony service. Call our toll-free number. Then you can record a voice message for a prospect. That also didn't work out. We got to realize that people are expressing themselves through voice or video. you knock that feature. In the early days of Bharat Matrimony evolution, we should do what you call a swimmer, a matrimony meet, a targeting a particular community, say Brahmin matrimony meet in Indore. So we should do this kind of meet across India. This physical meet was limited by the number of people who can able to participate. If you do the matrimony meet in, say, Mumbai, for Marathas, only certain people can be able to come. When the people come also, they're limited by matching a different age, different occupation. We thought it's a good feature, but a challenge of taking this in various markets in a large scale. We came with the idea called virtual matrimony meet. What is virtual matrimony meet is that for a particular community, we announce well in advance the Brahmin matrimony meet happening on so-and-so day. So people across the world can log into a particular time, they can interact with the prospects. So we launched a virtual matrimony meet. Then another interesting idea we launched, look-alike. Because you have a dream girl, dream boy in your mind. You want to get married to the girl like Aishwarya Rai, but there's only one Aishwarya Rai. Married to Abhishek Bachchan, say, okay, fine, obviously. But look-alike, you can upload your favorite celebrities. The system will match the photo and show the similar matching brides or groom. We thought, cool idea, because you have dream boy, dream girl, upload their picture, we get the matching prospect. But one incident happened, one guy uploaded a monkey and got some picture. It got published in the social media. Look at what kind of software these guys had developed. Upload a monkey also, it shows some prospects. We said, look, it's not a nice feature, you knock that feature. They basically thinking of how the Bharat Matrimony evolved was how to take the real world matchmaking into the virtual. It's not real time, it's a real world matchmaking into the virtual world. It's not about a starting business, because even Mr. Kapoor talking about the technology has been changing so rapidly. If they don't adapt, if you don't change with the changing times, will not be relevant anymore. Bharat Matrimony pioneered so many things in change with the changing time. 10 years ago or 7-8 years ago, we launched when the short SMS were popular, a short code was popular. We thought, why not launch a matrimony service through SMS? We got the short code 50-50 across the various service provider. Through SMS, you can do the life partner search. SMS, certain keywords to the 50-50 short code. We realized it was not that easy to do the live partner search through short code. We knocked that feature. One of the constant questions people used to ask me was, how about Facebook is coming? The Facebook have millions of profile. Don't you think a Facebook is a threat to you? A smart business converts problems into an opportunity. We, instead of seeing Facebook as a threat, we converted Facebook into an opportunity. So what we did was, you give your Facebook ID, you give your LinkedIn ID, you give your Twitter ID. What it does is, it gets the information from the Facebook, LinkedIn, because in Facebook, you're able to show a you and prospect also common friends. Basically, through Facebook, you could identify whether you have the common friends between both of you. It also gets the information from your likes and other hobbies and information pulled from Facebook. Again, you are given the occupation in bharatmatrimony.com. You may say, I'm a senior software engineer, but doesn't talk about how you have progress. If you give a LinkedIn ID, we automatically pull those information from LinkedIn. Basically, we leverage a social media to enrich Bharat Matrimony profile. So that way, the Bharat Matrimony profile enhanced with the social profile. And today we use analytics strongly to show the better matching profile. So you do a lot of algorithm. You know that this kind of persons like these kind of girls. So matchmaking driven by a lot of analytics and algorithms. We know that mobile is growing very fast. Today, close to 50% of profiles for Bharat Matrimony are coming from the mobile, both app and web. We have more than 1 million apps downloaded through our Android app and iOS app. Basically, it's important that the business need to continuously evolve, adapt, and change with the changing technology. If you don't change, you'll be gone. So we are continuously changing and will change with the changing times. So Bharat Matrimony was started as online matchmaking site. We realized that we can expand and get more market share. We realized that not every person could be comfortable in doing the matchmaking by himself or herself. We thought if India is outsourcing, or India is getting outsourced by the multinational companies, and the people are busy doing their work, why not people outsource their matchmaking to us? we launch assisted matrimony service, meaning instead of you doing the matchmaking by yourself, let our relationship manager take care of your matchmaking. So in the process, we're able to charge 19,000 rupees for 3 months compared to 3,800 for online matchmaking. So our prospect take care of searching, shortlisting, contacting prospect on behalf of you. A lot of rich and affluent people, they can pay more money. We launched Elite Matrimony, targeting the rich and affluent people, where we charge 50,000 rupees for 3 months, exclusive matrimony service for the rich and affluent and celebrities. You all know that marriage in India is not happened within the same language speaking people alone. Marriage in India, by and large, happened within the community. Way back, 10 years ago, after launching Bharat Matrimony, in few years, we realized that the future competition for Bharat Matrimony will be in the likes of a community-specific matrimony site. So what we did was, for all the community, what is community? Like-minded people is community. A religion is a community. A caste is a community. We launch our own competition under the brand called communitymatrimony.com. Basically, 300 plus sites for every community, whether it's a Kayastha, whether it's a Agarwal, whether it's a Patel matrimony, Agarwal matrimony, Iyer matrimony, Iyengar matrimony, for every religion, Christian matrimony, Muslim matrimony, Jain matrimony, Buddhist matrimony, even defense matrimony, because defense is a community by itself. We also launch a site for 40 plus matrimony, because once you cross the age of 40, better get married. So no, that's a community by itself. Like that, we have created a competition called Community Matrimony. Today, that's become one of the largest matrimony site. Not only limited by only by online or assisted matchmaking service, we also taken the matchmaking to the retail format, because a lot of parents would be comfortable walking to the physical outlets where can avail the matchmaking service. Today, we are running 190 company-owned Bharat Matrimony outlets across India. Basically, what we did was, what was just one online business, we were able to segment what we call horizontal segmentation. Horizontal segmentation is the value innovation like assisted elite matrimony, a vertical segmentation based on community. So one business of matchmaking became a four business of matchmaking. In the process, we grew better. So now, having become the strong leader in online matchmaking, now we are getting into marriage services. Because India knows how much money being spent on the marriage, which is a $50 billion+ market opportunity. So what we are getting into, we have matrimonydirectly.com, which has 50,000 listing of people in the wedding letter services. We recently are doing a service called matrimony photography, wedding photography service in Chennai, which will definitely look at expanding it. Basically, from matchmaking, the company getting into marriage services. Finally, the purpose. What is our purpose? The future of the country depends on its citizens. A good citizen come out of good parenting. Good parenting is possible only happy marriage, and we want to be the gateway to the happy marriage. The single line for Bharat Matrimony, building a better Bharat through happy marriages. That's the future. If we get the families right, we get the citizen right, get the citizen right, we get the country right. So what you are going to do? You are not only putting at the purpose, you already started working on it. We're going to launch a website called happymarriages.com. People don't have understanding of marriage. They're getting divorced for simple reasons. We want to bring the wisdom of what is marriage. Marriage is such a beautiful thing. We want to bring the wisdom of how to make marriage successful. So happymarriage.com will going to be the resource or support for people to understand marriage, will make marriage successful, thereby making family successful, thereby making the good citizen go and build a better Bharat. So when you go back my life, in 1997, I did not have an idea what I want to do. No idea. After 2.5 years, I hit up an idea called matrimony. So 2.5 years, no idea became idea. Initially, I was not passionate about matrimony. When you continue to do something, over a period of time, what I was doing continuously, the idea became the passion. The passionately building matrimony.com today became a purpose. Actually, to make business successful, you need 3 things. We need idea, we need how big the idea, we need a team to execute. But if you have large enough purpose, all 3 taken care. Because a large enough purpose is as the idea, is a big enough idea, the purpose will make you to execute and drive things. So what, how that's, and again, Bharat Matrimony initially was the last choice. Today it's become the one of the primary choice for people who want to look for life partner. This is the story of Bharat Matrimony, and end with one small thing what you launched recently. We recently launched an app called Good Makes Noise. Because in the media, in the world, what you only see is the only the sensational news. Bad is making the noise. We thought, why not provide avenue for people to promote the goodness? The Good Makes Noise is an app, a free app currently available only in Android. When you come across good, heard good, experience good, spread goodness. Let the goodness spread. So this app you launch, I request all the people to download this app, Good Makes Noise. Let's spread the goodness. Thank you for the opportunity.